Hello and welcome back to another study vlog. So if you're new here, I'm Shweta and I'm a research student studying and living in the Netherlands. And before we get started, I would like to thank PDF Element for kindly sponsoring this video. Nowadays, we are studying and working online and we have to deal with PDF documents regularly. With PDF Element, you can highlight and underline the important text. Plus, you can add comments, which is really helpful. You can also convert PDF files to Word, Excel, and PowerPoint, which saves a lot of time. And the best part is you can retain the original layout. The feature which I use the most and is very helpful for me is the OCR tool. All you have to do is perform the OCR on your scanned document. You can also set language, and once it's done, you can copy, edit, and search text from the scanned documents. I think this is a very powerful feature of PDF Element and it saves a lot of time. Earlier, it was always a hustle to edit the scanned documents using the built-in PDF editor in my laptop. But PDF Element has made things easier for me. As a student, we constantly have to fill forms, be it admissions or exam forms. With PDF Element, you can fill the form, sign it digitally, and the form recognition tool allows you to extract data from the filled PDF forms. PDF Element is definitely a useful tool and makes working with PDF documents easier. Download and discount links are below in the description. So my day began pretty early today. I woke up at 5:30, surprisingly, not for studies but for a meeting. This meeting was cancelled several times due to time differences, but this time I did not want to postpone it again. Even though the meeting was at 6 in the morning for me, it was 10:30 according to the Indian time. So I quickly freshen up and attend the meeting. For the first 5 to 10 minutes, it was really difficult to focus, but somehow I made through it. It was a good 1 hour meeting and I needed a cup of tea. I thought of studying for some time but somehow did not find the motivation to get started. It was a bright sunny day, so I decided to go for a quick run. After coming back, I cleaned my apartment, took a shower. I began by going through the research papers for my ongoing project. I always jot down and highlight important points of the paper so that I can always go through it later. As I woke up early, I was hungry, so I went on to make lunch. But then I realized I had to do my laundry as well. The clothes have been piling up for long. The slot between 12 to 2 p.m. is usually free, so I decided to go ahead with washing my clothes. Doing laundry is pretty convenient here in my new apartment. We have an app to book the machine and we can pay via the app itself. As soon as the washing machine was available, I put the clothes for washing. And in the meantime, I prepared a good Indian meal and enjoyed it with my all-time favorite series, Big Bang Theory. I did the dishes. Laundry was done by then, so got the clothes back as well. After spending half of the day, I had only studied for a couple of hours, so I got my study mode on and I started reading for the membrane biology course which I am currently following. To keep up the study spirit and avoid dozing off, I started working on figures for the article I'm writing. And this second study session demanded a second cup of tea. I took a 15 minutes break and got back to studying. Here I am reading for another interesting course that is on healthcare technology. So there was a parcel for me. My laboratory animal science course certificate finally arrived. Also, I realized that it was already 8:15 and I needed to have dinner. So for such scenarios, khichdi is the answer. After dinner, I got into my PJs and then I listened to music and take a walk for some time. After that, I moved to my couch for further studies. It seems like a very long day, but it was a productive one. I spent most of the time doing household chores, but managed to study for 8 to 10 hours and I feel good about it. And as I always say, at the end of the day, you should feel happy and satisfied about your study and your study time. Then I follow my regular night routine. And get into my bed. I make sure that I read for some time before I sleep. And I'm currently reading Free to Focus by Michael Hyatt. I hope you found this video somewhat entertaining and motivating. And if you have made this far into the video, I'm guessing you like it. So please do hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Until then, stay safe and take care.